During the years before the American Civil War, the path to freedom was the Underground Railroad for many slaves held in the South. The paths these slaves traversed went through the rugged mountains and hills of what is now West Virginia. These paths the guides would lead these slaves to freedom on was a favorite due to there being many places to hide. These treacherous trails sometimes led to accidental deaths for those traversing them. There is a tall, steep hill that is almost entirely covered with loose rock near the town of Parsons. There is only one path over this hill, and it is nearly impassable and dangerous. The hill is called Darkish Knob, and among residents, it has long had a reputation for being haunted. The Underground Railroad was busy bringing as many slaves as possible to the north. These escaped slaves had to travel at night, hiding and sleeping in the daytime, so that they wouldn't be seen. On one trip, the guides had to switch up paths and safe houses to throw authorities off their scent. Traveling at night through the deadly passes could be treacherous to the slaves who traveled the Underground Railroad. These slaves, though, would be tortured and killed if they were caught, so they pressed on traveling these trails most people wouldn't even attempt in the day. One of these trails was over the top of Darkish Knob. On the side of the mountain there was a safe house hidden so well, that if you didn't know it was there you wouldn't find it. Many guides used this safe house to hide with slaves until nightfall. One cold moonless night, a young girl was trying to locate the safe house. She was being chased by men who had been hired to find runaway slaves and missed the house and started up the trail over Darkish Knob. She rode her horse to the top of the hill and along the path that drops down into the Cheat River. As she reached the top, she turned and looked back. The horse lost his footing and plunged over the edge of the hill. As the girl fell to the rocks below, she let out a bellowing scream that was heard for nearly a mile. The ghost of this young girl is said to return to the top of the hill every year on the eve of the date of her death. The ghost moans and cries for several minutes and then lets out a terrifying scream as the moment of her death approaches. About 15 years ago, I was working as a supervisor out Route 7 towards 100. I was never once a believer in the paranormal, but after I tell you these few tales you will know why I am now. This area is littered with well paths. There's an average of about 100 sites in the back of Wetzel County. One night I was working the graveyard shift when one of my drivers came storming in the door of my office all worked up. I couldn't make heads or tails of what he was saying at first. I told him to take a breath and relax. He did so and then started to tell me what happened. He was bringing back a couple of trucks from one of the well pads on Macedon Road, way out on Route 89. He said he was in the lead, of course, because he was the pilot truck, and he came up upon a lady in a white dress and black hair. He was shocked at first by what he was seeing, and then the truck driver behind him radioed and asked him if he was seeing the lady also. They all three passed her due to there being no safe place to pull over nearby. They went up the road about 10 yards and pulled over. They all got out to investigate, but the lady was gone. Now mind you, this area of road has a long drop off one side and almost straight up mountain on the other. There was no way she could have went off the road on either side without them being able to see her still. They were a little freaked out by this. Truck drivers in the area have told rumors about a mysterious hitchhiker on this road. I told my driver that it was probably just a reflection of light or maybe a local who lived nearby. Now I didn't believe it to be a local who lived nearby due to a lot of people not living on this road and the houses that were out there are rundown. This explanation did put my driver at ease though. Business went as usual for the next 2 weeks. Didn't take long for my next driver to experience something strange. If you are from West Virginia or better Wetzel or Tyler County, then you have probably heard about the Jennings Gang. The Jennings Gang terrorized New Martinsville and the surrounding areas from about 1865 till 1873. The story of the Jennings Gang is long one, so I will save that one for another time, but I will say this: the town of New Martinsville got fed up with the Jennings Gang robbing and killing people. They took it upon themselves to raid the hideout and string up Frank Jennings. They reported that they only killed Frank Jennings, but other tales contradict that story. My great-grandfather believed that they only reported killing Frank to keep the feds out of the area. This particular day, I was just finishing up with my shift when I got a phone call from one of my most senior drivers. He told me that he was out on Doolin Run Road and could hear gunshots. I could hear them through the phone as well. Now I don't know if it was because I was hearing them through the phone, but the gunshots sounded very odd. It was just getting dusk out, and I told him to just stay in his truck and come back as soon as the other trucks were done on the pad. He said okay and hung up. Not even 2 minutes later, I hear one of the drivers on the well on Doolin say, "Is that gunshots?" Then I heard someone say, "Hey, look over there." The radio then went dead. I called my driver to see what was happening and if they needed the sheriff. He told me that right after he got off the phone with me that the drivers on the pad heard the shots, and then they all looked up on the ridge towards Camp Run and saw four individuals on horseback galloping up over the ridge. I couldn't help but think of all the stories my pappy told me about the gang. I was just as stunned as they were, and I wasn't even there. The very next night, one of my traffic controllers quit in the middle of his shift. I asked him what happened. He said he was sitting in his truck with the windows cracked due to it being July. He was sitting in the parking lot of the old church located on Low Gap Road when suddenly, he heard people talking on all sides of the truck. He tried to find out where I was coming from, but it was pitch black out. He reported that they were saying like, "Who is he?" and, "Why is he here?" He tried to start his truck and the engine wouldn't turn over. By this time, he was really freaked. He tried to get on the radio, but the voices were coming through that as well. I'll tell you. This man was about 6'5" and 250 pounds. He was so scared he bolted from his truck and started running towards Route 7. He turned back and looked after he go to the bottom of the hill, and he saw a man dressed in a confederate uniform standing on the hill across from the church. I am retired now, but I will never forget these things happening to my people. It's hard when there is nothing you can do about it. I am a firm believer now.